Hi, this is Magnus with LMI. In Gocator 4.0 firmware, we introduced the concept of flexible anchoring. This is the ability to use any tool that produces X, Y, Z positions as results and use those as anchors for the regions of other measurement tools. To show that off, I'm going to scan this thin rubber strip. It has a sort of a varying width here along the part, and it has a groove on either side. So switching into the Gocator web interface, I'm in profile mode, and when I start running the sensor here, we get this profile, 3D profile over the rubber strip. You can see the two grooves on either side. So now I go to the measure page here. And the first step here is I'm going to create my anchors. So I add a profile position tool, and I position the region of that tool to cover the entire field of view, because I want to track the object in the entire field of view. So I'm going to rename this tool the left anchor. And I'm going to say that the feature we're going to track here is the leftmost point. Now I'm going to add another profile position tool and do the same thing with it. I'm going to position the region of that to cover the entire field of view. I'm going to rename it to the right anchor. And I'm going to say that the feature we're tracking is the rightmost point of this object. So now I have my anchors, and now I'm going to add the actual measurement I want to do on this part. So I'm going to add a profile dimension tool, and let's say in this tool I want to measure the width of the leftmost groove on this rubber strip. So I'm going to have to shrink my regions here quite a lot, since this is a small part. So I carefully position my measurement tools for my application here in the just the right location for my groove. And these two regions here, I'm going to track the left corner and the right corner of this groove. As you can see, we're now measuring the width here. If I'm going to turn on absolute numbers here, we can see that the width is approximately 2.2 millimeters here. And then I'm going to anchor this measurement to my left anchor. You can see now that when I enable the anchor, I can see that the anchor feature is shown with a white bullseye, and my two feature boxes turn white to indicate that I'm actively anchoring here. So let's do the same thing here for my other groove on the other side. So I add another profile dimension tool. I have to shrink down these feature boxes for this tool as well. So here we go. And I'm going to do the same thing here, of course. So I'm going to track the left corner and the right corner and report the absolute width here, and as you can see, we have a similar size groove on this side. So now I enable anchoring for this as well, but now I'm going to anchor to the right side of the rubber strip. So now you can see that I have my two measurements anchored. So if I scan over this part here now with the varying width, you will see that the tool for the right groove follows the right edge like that. And if I look at my other tool on the left side, it moves relative to the left edge. So this is something that was missing in previous versions of the Gocator, where we had a concept of profile fixturing, but it only allowed one single anchor. Finally here, I'd also like to point out that we can anchor in Z. So that would be in the height dimension here. So let's say that for my left anchor, for example, I'm enabling the Z measurement in height here. So now if I go back to my measurement tool of the groove and I enable anchoring in Z, and I lift up my rubber strip here, you will see that my feature boxes follow the object both in X and in height. Thank you for listening.